Hey guys, looks like the hi-fi audiophile power cord has come in. I had someone ask me why I don't just build one. I've actually been building them since 2001. If I find any pictures, I'm pretty sure I have backup of all the power cords that I've made. I'll put them in this video in the corner of the picture, and you can have a quick look at it. But yeah, I like these ones have been bugging me for a while. I was just curious. I wanted to see what it's like. I needed one for the tube buffer anyway, so I could figure, after I'm done taking this apart and going over it, I can just basically use it no matter what condition it's in. It does feel pretty light, so I don't even know if it's got legitimate copper or not. It might be aluminum, but we're gonna tear into this. This is not a review, just going over it. Yeah, I need both hands for this. Let me put you over top here. Somewhat of a good view. That doesn't look too bad. And for someone who has been building these in the past, it would cost you more than $29 to build this yourself. These would what I would call, well, I wouldn't say they're totally sealed, but they would be called hospital grade, because you can see right through them. You can see what's going on. We're actually going to take one apart. Crazy old lady in the basement. That looks pretty good. That ground pin there is a little, I don't know, questionable. Won't take me long to break that off. We're gonna remove one of these just to see the gauge of the wire. Let's see what I got here. The braiding is nice. I like that. Here we go. I can tell you right now, considering, well, okay, the wire is not bad. It's copper. I thought it was thinner than this by the looks of it through the plastic, but it's not that bad, actually. It's thicker than the cord, and it's actually copper. Sweet. Okay, no complaints here. For $29, it's, it's not bad. If you don't want to build your own, yeah, I'd go for it. This one here is 4.9 feet for 29 bucks, which is just a good deal. If you were to build this yourself, it would cost you twice as much, so. But at least it's copper, it's not aluminum. Yeah, so no problems with this. I like it. Yeah, I feel like I got my money's worth. I haven't even used it yet. The only thing I don't like is this ground pin is, I think it's too long. That's just my opinion. And it seems to be flimsy. Like, it feels like it's gonna snap right off. Anyway, other than that, this is nice and thick. Doesn't feel like it's gonna break or anything like that, or shatter. I'm happy with the purchase. Saves me from building it. The other side. It's nice and solid. You know, it'd be even cooler if they even put a little light in there. Yeah, even when you plug it in, it'd show that it's active. Anyway, let me get this back together and we'll set it up with the tube amp. Yeah, so it's a half decent product. I'm really surprised they don't actually have a name of it. It just says Hi-Fi Audiophile Power Cord. There's a model number on it. C-037. But it just says premium affordable audiophile AC power cable. Extremely high quality, very nice looking. Yeah. Good description of it. Let's go plug it in and see what it looks like. Well, not bad. She went in there nice and snug. It's not loose or anything. Worked with the new plug I just put on the tube amp. The nylon wrapping matches my RCAs that I just wrapped. So that's a bit of a bonus there. Yeah, no problems whatsoever with that. I would buy another one if I needed it. I'm not doing a mod on this receiver that needs it, so that would need it. But I figured I'd try it out and let you have a look on the inside if it was any good or not. And there, for $29, you're getting, yeah, it's pretty much a deal. By the time you get the cable together, the length of it, plus the two ends, plus the wire and the wrap and the shrink tubing, it's over $29. I don't even know how he makes money on that. I really don't. But no complaints. Later, guys.